There are many different ways that you can support different families in your community. One way that people support their community is through a food pantry. Today, we get to go behind the scenes to see how a food pantry uses math every single day.
Doodly doodle, doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too, it's all here for you.
Hi, I'm Kathy Hoff. I'm the Executive Director at People in Need, Inc. of Delaware County, Ohio. I am in the food pantry. This is where our volunteers will shop for families that come to our pantry services.
How do you use math?
We use math every day, from counting items to make sure we're giving people the appropriate amount for a 3 or 4 day meal supply. We serve about 400 residents a week. We need to prepare to have enough food to meet that need of 400 families. That involves a lot of math as well, because some families have 1 to 2 people in their family. Some families have 10 people. We need to make sure that we're ready to serve any size family in our pantry when they come here. If we see that this crate will hold 7 boxes and then 8, 9, 10, we know that this is 10. So we're gonna need 40 more of those, because 40 times 10 is 400. A lot of our food comes from Mid-Ohio Food Collective, which is in downtown Columbus. So they actually come to people in need with fresh produce or our canned food items. We get about half of what we distribute through drives that are done in the community. From one school food drive, we usually will have enough to serve 200 families. 200 families is what most schools will do a drive for.
Do you use decimals?
When people make donations, we weigh it on a scale in our warehouse, and then we assign it a dollar value. Food by pounds is $1.70. So every pound of food that we have that comes in donated to us, we have to multiply that by $1.70 to give the value of what that contributed good was.
How do you have to estimate?
A part of our budgeting process is to estimate for the next year how many people we think we're gonna serve, and then assign a dollar value to how much in contributed goods we need to raise, and then how much in dollar amounts we need to raise. So we have to give a guesstimate on what it would cost to feed those people.
What is something that might surprise students about your job?
People who come to a food pantry can be anyone. We have other people that may have experienced a job loss or something else that really requires them to come to our food pantry. And the really cool part about that is a lot of those people who utilize our services, when things get better for them, they are now a donor. They will come back and give back to their community.
The food pantry needs 500 boxes of cereal for the week. They currently have 345 boxes. How many more boxes of cereal do they need? I did 500 minus 345 equals 155 cereal boxes.
Kids can help by giving to other families or kids what you like to eat. If it's something that you would eat, I guarantee you there's another kid who would eat that too. You give what you love to make somebody else be so happy. This is People in Need, and this is how it's math.
Want more information about how math is used in the real world? Make sure you check out our website, www.doodleslearning.com. Bye!